One little girl in a pale pink coat, her
lay o la lay o la la hee hoo.
She yodeled back to the lonely goer,
lay o la lay o la loo.
Soon her mama the gleaming coat, her
lay o la lay o la la hee hoo.
What touch of words for a girl and goat, her
lay o la lay o la loo. Oh ho, lady o la lay, oh oh ho, lady o la lay. Oh ho, lady o la lay, oh lady o la lay, oh lay.
Now sing seriously. Liesl, give us a key.
Do.
So.
That's nice. Very nice. Except it's no good. Imagine you're all standing on a stage of a big concert hall.
What concert hall, Uncle Max?
Any concert hall. Maybe the Codsburg concert hall. A concert hall filled with people. Now, once more.
Do.
So.
Gretel, why don't you sing loud?
I've got a sore finger.
There. Now you can sing loud for Uncle Max. At the night of the party, you sung so beautifully with such spirit. Well, let's try it again.
Do.
So.
The children wanted to sing for me, the darlings. But they don't sing as well as they used to.
We need Fräulein Maria.
We do not need Fräulein Maria. You can sing just as well with me.
But I have experience with choirs, quartets, glee.
Max, please. Now, what would you like to sing?
Do, a deer, a female deer. Re, a drop of golden sun. Me, a
Fräulein Maria we started with.
We are not to mention Fräulein Maria.
Come on, Max, I feel like a brisk walk.
That's just what I need. Is anyone using the car?
Now, what are you going to sing?
The hills are alive with the sound of music. With songs they have sung for a thousand years.
Louisa, you didn't play any of your jokes, any of your tricks on Fräulein Maria?
Only those she liked and laughed at.
You didn't put toads in her bed?
No, Father.
Well, something must have happened. For her to leave without even saying goodbye?
Is it Fräulein Maria coming back?
No, darling. I don't think so.
But she was the best governess we ever had.
You're not going to need another governess.
Oh, good.
I'm not sure that's so good.
Well, you're going to have a new mother.
A new mother?
Frau Schrader?
That's right. It was all arranged last night. I am very happy. Well, it's time for my afternoon walk.
When Fräulein Maria wanted to feel better, she used to sing that song. Remember?
Yes.
All right, let's try it.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens.
Bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens. Brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Why don't I feel better?
Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes.
Snowflakes that stay on my
Maria!
Silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things.
When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Oh, children, I'm so glad to see you. I have to find your father right away.
I'll go find him.
I'll go with you.
How's your sore finger?
You remember it.
Liesl, are you all right?
Yes, Fräulein, I'm all right.
Many telegrams lately?
No, Fräulein. Now I'll be happy to go to boarding school.
Liesl, you can't use boarding school to escape your problems. You have to face them.
Oh, I have so much to tell you.
We have some things to tell you, too.
Well, you must have a great deal to tell me.
I guess the most important thing is that Father's going to be married soon.
Married?
To Frau Schrader.
Are you sure?
Yes. He told us. He told us himself.
We found him.
Liesl?
Luisa, bring it to boys. Maria will be in the nursery.
You've come back.
Yes, Captain.
You left us with no explanation whatsoever. Without even saying goodbye.
It was very wrong of me. Forgive me.
Why did you do this to us? Tell
me. Please don't ask me. Besides, the reason no longer exists.
So you're back to stay?
Well, only until arrangements can be made for another governess.
Oh, no. The children have missed you very much. I've missed you very... We have all missed you very much. Nothing was the same while you were away. Everything was wrong.
But I...
We'll talk about it later. Go to the children. Maria, a new dress?
We have a new postulant.
I know I'm right, Max. We'll find him and ask him.
I'll take your word for it, Elsa.
Georg, settle this for me and Max, will you? How far down the mountain does your property go?
Can you make up that stone wall? That's the property line.
You see?
I didn't argue.
I know. That makes me furious. I don't like to win without a fight.
Edweiler, while you were gone, you had a long-distance call from Berlin.
Oh, who could be calling me from Berlin?
They said you know who it was.
Ah, yes. Thank you, Franz.
Georg, what was it we were just talking about?
Max. This isn't your first call from Berlin.
Georg, you know I have no political conviction. Can I help it if other people do?
Let's not stir that up again. The Germans have promised not to invade Austria. Max knows that.
Then why does he bother answering their calls?
Because if they don't keep their promise, I want to have friends among them.
Naturally.
Oh, you agree too?
Georg, this is the way I see it. There's a man who is dying. They're giving him his last rite. They tell the man, do you renounce the devil and all his works? And the man says, at this moment, I prefer not to make enemies.
Georg, if they should invade us, would you defy them?
Yes.
You know what might happen to you? To your property?
To your children?
To everyone close to you? To Elsa? To me?
Well, what will you do?
If anyone of any sense would do, just sit tight and wait for it all to blow over.
And you think it will?
Well... One thing for certain, nothing you could do can make any difference.
Don't look so serious, darling. Take the world off your shoulders. Relax.
Call from Berlin, sir.
I'll call them back.
You might as well talk to them now, Max.
Go, go, go.
Georg, I feel I know what's going to happen here. Can't you see things my way?
Not if you're willing to see things their way.
There's one thing you do better here than we do in Vienna. Your sunset. I'm going to miss them.
Captain, I... Oh, I beg your pardon.
Maria! Georg, you didn't tell me Fräulein Maria was back. I'm delighted.
Thank you. Captain, the children would like to know if they could take a holiday from their lessons tomorrow so that we can all go on a picnic.
Yes. I don't mind.
Oh, that'll make them very happy. And may I be permitted to wish you happiness too, Frau Schrader? Captain, the children tell me you're going to be married.
Oh, I'm afraid the children were wrong. I've got to finish packing if I'm going to get back to Vienna.
If you feel you must. I'll tell Franz to have the car ready.
I can do that. Auf Wiedersehen, Georg. Goodbye, Maria.
I'm sorry if I said something I shouldn't have said.
You said the wrong thing. But at the right time...
The children told me you're going to be marrying Frau Schrader.
Yes. We found we couldn't go the same way. That door is shut.
Sister Margaret always says, when God shuts a door...
I know. He opens a window. Maria, Why did you run away to the abbey? What made you come back?
The Mother Abbess, she said you have to look for your life.
Oftentimes when you find it, you don't recognize it.
No.
Not at first. Then all of a sudden, one day, one night, it stands before you.
Yes.
I look at you now and I realize this is not something that I've known all of a sudden. This is something I've known deep inside of me for weeks now. You've known it too. What was it that told you?
Brigida, she said that other night when we were dancing.
Yes. That wasn't an ordinary dance, was it?
I haven't danced since I was a very little girl.
When you were a very little girl, did a very little boy ever kiss you?
Uh-huh.
That's quite different, too.
Is it? It is different.
Oh, Maria, your whole life will be different now. I'll take you anywhere you go, give you anything you wish.
But I don't want to go anywhere. All I could wish for is right here.
And those two should really get together.
Who?
The Mother Abbess and Brigitte. Maria? Is there someone I should go to ask for your hand in marriage?
Well, why don't we ask
the children?
I brought a mirror. It's in my suitcase.
Sister Berta?
Sister Margareta!
Well, I don't think she's had time to put in the linings.
Sister Berta, the mirror?
My mother, I look...
Don't be vain, my daughter. I'll say it for you. You are indeed beautiful, my dear.
Thank you.
Children, children! Liesel, Friedrich, Marta, Gretel, Kirk! See? Carlsberg Festival 1938. The family von Trapp singers. And here are all your names. Liesel, Friedrich, Brigitte, Luisa, Kurt, Marta, and Gretel.
Why am I always last?
Because you're the youngest.
Liesel, I'm depending on you. Day after tomorrow, you and the children must be ready by 11 o'clock. That is when...
Herr Detweiler, can you help me, please? The Galter is here and he wants to know where we are finding the new flag.
Heil!
I tried to explain.
Keep quiet.
When is Captain von Trapp returning?
Who knows when a man's on their honeymoon?
These are not times for joking. It's been 4 days since the Anschluss. And this is the only house in the province that's not flying the flag of the Third Reich!
You mean the flag with the black spider on it?
Jesus!
Could you permit such remarks in this house? Who are you?
I am Maximilian Detweiler, first secretary in the Ministry of Education and Culture.
Ah, that was in the old regime.
In the old regime, I was third secretary. Now, I am first secretary.
Good, then you will order them to fly the flag.
I couldn't! I can only take orders from Captain von Trapp.
You will take orders from us, and so will the captain! Heil!
Heil!
Why is he so cross?
Everybody's cross these days.
Is father going to be in trouble?
He doesn't have to be. The thing to do today is to get along with everybody. Now, you and the children must be at the bus by 11 o'clock.
Uncle Max, do you think this will be all right with father?
Oh, he'll be pleased and proud.
Liesel, do you think so?
Brigitte, don't you trust me?
No.
Well, anyways, the bus leaves at 11 o'clock.
Fräulein Liesel, see what I have here?
That's father's luggage!
Yes, sit back.
Liesel, they have such a lot to tell us. Let's not hurry and tell them anything.
They're back!
Max!
Georg, we weren't expecting you back till next week.
Max, it's wonderful to see you. There's much I want to know.
Oh, children, we missed you so very much.
What did you miss the most?
Well, we missed all that noise you make in the morning.
That noise you make telling each other to be quiet? We wish going upstairs to wish you good night.
We missed hearing you sing.
Well, you're back just in time to hear us sing. Look, Father, we're going to be singing the Carlsberg Festival Friday night.
Let me see that. Max. Are you responsible for this?
I was just waiting to talk to you about it, Georg.
You can't talk your way out of this one.
Presents!
I want one! Georg, I had to make a last-minute decision. I was very fortunate to enter them all. They'll be the talk of the town. 7 children in 1 family.
Not my family.
The committee heard them. They were enchanted.
Oh, really, Max? What did they say?
You never heard such praise.
Oh, Georg, did you hear?
The von Trapp family does not sing publicly.
But if they make people happy...
And for the festival, people come all over the world!
It is out of the question.
Georg, it's for Austria!
There is no Austria.
But the Anschluss happened peacefully. We can at least be grateful for that!
Grateful?! To these swine?
You must at least pretend to work with these people. I admire the way how he feels, but you need to talk to him. He needs to compromise.
No, Max.
Maria, you must.
Max, I can't make Georg be any less than what he is.
Then I'll talk to him. If these children don't sing for the festival, well, it would be a reflection on Austria. It wouldn't do me any good.
Maria, I've always known you loved us children. Now I know you love father.
I do, Liesel. I love him very much.
How can you be sure?
Well, because now I don't think first of myself. I think first of him. I know now how to spend my love.
A bell is no bell till you ring it. A song is no song till you sing it. And love in your heart was important you stay. Love isn't love till you give it away. When you're 16, going on 17, waiting for life to start,
after it happens, nothing is quite the same. Somehow you know you'll jump up and go if ever he calls your name.
Gone are your old ideas of life, the old ideas grow dim. Lo and behold, you're someone's wife, and you belong with him. You may think this kind of adventure
There's a telegram for the captain.
Rolf! Rolf, I'd like it to meet my mother, my new mother.
Rolf, I'm glad to meet you finally.
I have a telegram for Captain Von Trapp.
You stay here with Lisa. I'll take it.
I'm under orders to make sure the captain gets it.
Well, I'm sure you can trust me to give it
to
him.
I have my orders.
Silly, they're married.
Oh, Franz, the telegram is to be delivered into the hands of Captain Von Trapp.
Heil!
Heil!
Rolf!
Even Franz.
Yes, even Franz, even me. Even everyone in all of Nomburg except the great Captain Von Trapp. If he knows what's good for him, he'll come over to the right side.
Rolf, don't talk like that.
And if he doesn't, he'd better get out of the country. There are things that happen today to a man like that. He'd better get out quick. Cry all you want, but just remember what I said before it's too late. And you remember too.
Oh, Liesl, don't cry.
How could he turn on father that way?
Liesl, maybe he wasn't threatening your father. Maybe he was warning him.
Liesl.
What is it, Georg?
I wasn't expecting to have to make this decision so soon. Berlin has offered me a commission in the Navy.
Well, Georg?
I can't just brush this aside. I admit, it would be nice to have a ship under me again. What I mean is, it would be a comfort to know that you and the children are safe. But that also means, Maria, help me.
Georg, whatever you decide will be my decision.
Thank you. I know now I cannot do it.
Of course not.
We'll have to get out of Austria.
You'll have to leave soon, tonight.
Not without my family. But we can't just pick up and leave. They'll be watching us. We'll have to have time.
Heil!
We'll have to plan.
Sir, Admiral von Schreiber of the Navy, of the Third Reich, is here to see you.
Thank you, Franz. They didn't give us time.
Then we'll have to make time.
I'll let him in. We must be careful.
What's going on? Troopers? I was afraid of Maria.
Max, you stay here with Georg. Liesl, find the children, quickly.
It's under my shirt.
This way, Admiral von Schreiber. Herr Detweiler, may I introduce to you Admiral von Schreiber. Max, I'm sure you know Elzella. Would you gentlemen care to sit down?
We are here on business.
Captain von Trapp, a telegram was sent to you 3 days ago.
I have just received it. I've only been home half an hour.
Captain von Trapp has just returned from his honeymoon, sir.
Ah, congratulations, Captain.
Thank you.
Your record in the war is very well remembered by us.
It's very flattering to hear you say that, sir.
Let's get to the point.
If you don't mind. In our Navy, we hold you in very high regard. That's the reason I'm here. Having had not received an answer to our telegram, the High Command has sent me in person.
That's very flattering, sir, but I've had no time to consider.
I'm here to present you with your commission.
I am deeply conscious of the honor, sir.
And your orders are to report immediately to the naval base at Bremerhaven.
Immediately? Oh, I'm afraid that would be impossible for you, Georg.
Admiral von Schreiber, may I present to you my wife, the Baroness von Trapp.
Madam?
What I mean to say, sir, is that we're all performing in the Kaltzberg Festival Friday night. You see, the von Trapp family singers, they're in the program.
It's been arranged by the Ministry of Education and Culture.
Friday night? Well, this is Wednesday. That's only a matter of 2 days. It might be possible. You can report to Bremerhaven by Monday. Is there a telephone I could use?
This way, Admiral. If you have any questions, perhaps adding the weight of my voice.
It gives here only the names of the children.
It says Family von Trapp. I am head of the von Trapp family.
It's hard to believe that you, Captain von Trapp, singing in a concert.
Well, Elzella, you may believe what you choose.
It doesn't say here what you're going to be singing in the concert. What are you going to be singing?
It's your privilege to come to the concert and hear us.
I'd like to hear you sing now. Sing what you're going to sing in the concert. Sing.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. Lisa, will you give us a do?
Do.
Do, a deer, a female deer. Re, a drop of golden sun.
Me, a name I call myself.
Far a long, long way to run.
Pulling thread,
to follow song,
I know to follow song.
Ring the chant and bell.
drink with jam and bread.
With jam and bread.
A drink with jam and bread.
Jam and bread.
A drink with jam and bread.
Jam and bread.
Tea with jam and bread. Tea with jam and bread. Jam and bread. Jam and bread. Tea with jam. Jam and bread. Jam and bread.
Tea with jam. Jam and bread.
With ABC.
Gentlemen, thank you. Just a moment. I have an announcement that may concern you. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the conclusion of our festival, except we're not quite sure what the conclusion will be. The judges are putting their heads together to come up with a decision. And while we wait, I think there should be an encore. This seems this may be the last opportunity for the Von Trapp family to sing for a long, long time. I have just received word that Captain Von Trapp leaves immediately from this stage hall to his new naval command of the Third Reich. A guard of honor will escort him directly from this stage hall to his new naval command at Bremerheim. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the family Von Trapp again!
There's a sad sort of clanging from the clock in the hall.
This pretty sight. So long, farewell, Avita, saying adieu,
adieu, adieu to you and you and you.
So long, farewell, Avita, say goodbye. We flit, we float, we fleetly flee, we fly.
So long, farewell, Auf Wiedersehen, goodbye.
The sun has gone to bed and so must I.
Goodbye.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
I have here the decision of our distinguished judges. We shall start with third award. For this honor, the judges have named the duo sung buds of Havasia. For second prize goes to Fräulein Schweiger, first soloist of St. Agatha's Church in Mabach. And for first prize, the highest musical award of Ostmarch goes to the family von Trapp.
Where are they? The Von Trapps!
They're gone!
Gone? Hartman! Take the first sword! Heinrich! Launch the three-way! Steinhardt! Call the district headquarters!
Play something!
How many of them are there?
I counted 8 stormtroopers and their officers.
Sister Margareta, we didn't know we put the Abbey in this danger.
This is outrageous. The church has always been a sanctuary.
Not for these people. This is the third time they searched the Abbey. That's why we put you out here in the garden. They always search the inside, never the outside.
Isn't this God's house?
Shh.
Yes, darling.
We all must be very, very quiet. We'll let you know when they've gone.
After this is over, can we go home?
No, my darling. We have a long drive ahead of us.
Elisa, let's stay close to each other.
Lieutenant! No one out here, sir!
All right, come along.
They've gone.
Oh, thank God. Mother Abbess, we didn't know we put the Abbey in this much danger.
Reverend Mother, we can never thank you.
As soon as it's safe, we'll start. I've hid the car deep in the woods.
The car will do you no good. They've left a guard on the road in front of the gate.
I've been listening to the wireless. All the roads have been blocked, and the borders have been closed.
I've always thought these mountains to be my friends, standing there to protect us. Now they seem to have become my enemies.
Never your enemies, haven't you read? I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from whence come my help.
Georg, I know those mountains as well as I know this garden. And so do you. And once we're over the mountains, we're in Switzerland.
But the children.
We can help them.
Father, we can do without help.
You'll have help. For ye shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth before you into singing.
Follow every rainbow till you find your dream, a dream that will need all the love you can give. Every day of your life, for as long as you live, climb every mountain. Oh,
name is Kathy Ochoa, and I'm an assistant principal, and it was wonderful.
I'm Richard Marting. I'm the drama director at Godinez High School, and I was the drama director for the show. I love Sound Music. It's a timeless show. I was first introduced to it when I was in high school, and I just secretly loved it. And I'm so happy we finally got to do it. It's a huge cast, and there's so many different characters in it, and it was fun to having the kids create their own characters, making them come alive, and it's just amazing with such talent that so many kids have, from Mother Abbess to Maria to Max to just everyone bringing their own piece to the amazing puzzle that this makes.
My name's Jose Alvarez, and I love the show about the performance. They had incredible talent. They're such great actors, and I love the musicality they had during their performances.
Who did you come to see?
I came to see the actor who was playing the, I don't know if it was the Italian actor. He was such an amazing performance. He had great humor, and he was such an amazing actor.
My name is Valerie, and the thing I love more about being in this show is meeting a bunch of new people and just performing in front of people that we know and love. To all the young people out there, just face your fears, have some courage, and I promise it'll be a lot of fun.
I'm Emma Marting, and I'm playing Maria in The Sound of Music, and I think that this production was just especially really fun to work with because it was a unique experience to be able to work with people playing a variety of different characters, and it was really fun to kind of come into our own, and it was a blast to put on, and I can't wait for the next three performances. Yeah.
What would you tell younger kids that are in middle school or just coming up and then that want to do this? What would you tell them to do now while they're growing up?
Just get involved as much as you can. Try to, if you're really passionate about this, just find ways to make it happen because it'll really accumulate and then you'll be able to grow your talent and then really, really stand out as you enter high school, college, and the real world.
I'm Juan Mesa. I played Captain Von Trapp. And I think my favorite thing about this whole show was that it was so, it's such an old show, but it still had so many things that are relevant to today. And so I think going through all of this and, you know, really trying to figure out how we can make this feel so modern and present, it wasn't actually as hard as I would have thought it was, and it was just one of the most amazing things I could have ever been in. This is my last production as a senior, so I couldn't have asked for a better one. Go out and just don't be afraid to do anything. You can do anything you ever wished. I mean, I didn't know how to sing, I didn't know how to act, but freshman year I joined drama and I got the confidence. Sophomore year I first auditioned for my first play and musical and I gained confidence. Junior year they convinced me to do choir to build up my singing voice, and here I am senior year and I'm the lead of the musical and it's just so amazing.
I'm Stephanie Padilla and I play the Mother Abbess. What I love doing about the show is all the people I got to be with. I mean, all these friends I've been with since I was in musical theater, and I know a lot of my friends are graduating this year, so it's really hard for me to let go because this has been something I've been for a long time. What I really liked about the play was all the time I got to spend, because I know last year, it's really different from the show that we did last year, but it was the same kind of experience. You got to meet a whole lot of different people, and it was just so, so amazing making all those friendships with different people.
My name is Elaine, and I played Liesl in this musical, and I love the costumes, and I love my character. I couldn't be enough thankful to everybody that came.
My name is Robert Chavez. I did tech crew for the musical, and I really liked how everything went all well together. Everyone was being very cooperative, and it all went really well together.
Okay, how about John? What is it like working with John Westmeyer?
Well, John can be a little strict at first, but in the end, he really helps you learn everything about that there is to do with tech crew. So, yeah, it's all good.
My name is Victor Naranjo, and being this character in Nazi, it's weird taking this role because you see it's a very bad, controversial role, but yet, like, when you get into character, you kind of have to forget that. And get into character, you kind of have to believe that what you're doing is right, it's correct. And once you're out of it, you kind of be like, man, you started thinking about it, and you're like, oh, Nazis are terrible, but it's kind of this mental state you have to put yourself in where you let go of your views and you become the character. And that's what it takes to be a Nazi.
Hi, I'm Xavier Garza. I played as Kurt in this musical, and the thing I like the most is spending time with each other and pretty much singing as much as we can and as long as we can.
Hey, my name is Eric Lindsay, and I played as Maximilian Detweiler.
What did you like about being in the
I just love just being on stage and just like getting a new character and play around with it. And like, there's a lot of shows out there and I get to play with different ones. And I like this one. It's just like, this is the biggest lead I got for a musical.
What do you love about acting, being somebody else?
Acting, what I love is the escape. It's kind of a new you, but it's not you at all. You get to play a new version of like the character you made. You can take on a role and make it your own. It doesn't have to be the same as another person. You can nitpick and make something new out of it. And at the end, it's acting is really, really fun. I love it, and I'm not gonna let it go.
Hi, my name is Jeanette McMahon, and I am the Visual and Performing Arts Coordinator at Godinez Fundamental High School, and produced the show, The Sound of Music. And I just love the show. It's iconic music that everybody loves, and it's very toe-tapping, but it has a really sincere message. And the kids really clung to that as they participated in the show. Just doing shows at Godinez anyway are really fun. We have drops and the costumes, and even the tech crew learns how to do all the technical elements that are involved in putting on a great show. So it's just really fun for our kids. They love telling a story, and I'm really glad that we're able to bring this classic to the city of Santa Ana.
And what's coming up for you this summer?
Oh, this summer, the district musical is going to be The Little Mermaid, and we're going to be performing that July 19, 20, and 21st at Santa Ana High School. So be looking forward to that. It's going to be fully costumed, staged, dancers, orchestra, the whole thing. It'll be really exciting. So I hope to see you all there.